Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and Android Q Beta 2 is now available for developers. If you already have Beta 1, you can just go to Software Updates and Update. If you don't have it, I'll link in the description where you can actually check it out for yourself, sign up for the beta program, and enroll it for your Pixel device or other compatible devices. And you'll see here is the first change, and this is a notification bubble. So if I tap on this, you'll see that I have a notification. It's just my messages here. I can go through them and even downloads show up. You can turn this on or off. You have to actually use the ADB command line tool in order to actually enable these. Otherwise, they're not there. You can kind of move them around and you can turn them on for all notifications or just one. Now, if we open something like music, this is a new change as well. So maybe I'll play this music. So I played it, it kind of crashed the device, went to a black screen and came back. But after you play it, it actually shows up as a notification. And if I tap on the notification, it now tells me the actual duration that I've played the music. This is true for any media. It's no longer here. If I pull down, if you have the bubbles turned on, they show up like this. If you turn the bubbles off, they'll show up at the top, but that's what it looks like. So you can move these around and dismiss them down here. Drag and dismiss, and if a new one comes in, it just pops up as a little bubble. Now, volume settings have a new little pop-up panel, so if I turn on volume, hit the little button here, we've got a new little pop-up panel here, and you can also see more, and then you've got your settings right here. So that's a new little change. And then there's new swipe gestures as well, very similar to iOS. So if I go into, say, a web page and swipe, I can go back and forth between them just by running my finger across the bottom bar here. You can also tap and that works just fine, but again, you can swipe and all of the same gestures work just the same right now. Now, there's also a new music always on display, but you actually have to turn the chat bubbles off for that to show. So if I turn this off, go back here, we'll see if I can get it to show up for your ambient display. And it just went away. So let's see if I can get that to go on again. You'll see it gives a little bit more information for the music that's on your ambient display. So just gives a little bit more thorough information. Now, this little battery icon here is different. It's a new little icon, not a huge change, but something I guess to note. And then also when you're charging wirelessly, so I've got a wireless charger here, it will no longer say that it's fast or slow charging. Let's go to the lock screen. It will just say wirelessly charging. It never says fast or rapidly or slow anymore. So that's a change they've made as well. Now they've made some changes to the notifications. So let's go to settings. We'll go to notifications. So apps and notifications. And you'll see the apps are aligned left to right now horizontally instead of top to bottom. So that's a change. Then also notifications here. We also have a notification assistant. And if we go into this, you'll see notification assistant. If I tap on it, it says notification assistant will be able to read all notifications, including personal information such as contact names and text of messages you receive. It will also be able to modify or dismiss notifications or trigger action buttons they contain. So it just gives you all of this ability. We'll hit OK and go back. We also have some new swipe actions. So here we can swipe left to dismiss, right to show menu, or we can switch it the other way around depending on what we'd like to do. So that's new as well. Now, if we go back a few steps here, you'll see your actual account is more integrated into the OS, it seems. So even in search, it's right here. So let me tap on my name here and it will bring up this display and it just gives a little bit more information and it's more personalized right in the settings and it's sort of tied right into the OS that way. Now, if we go back to the settings page here, we go to apps. You'll see it's now called Permission Manager. It's no longer Apps Manager. So they've changed the name of that for permissions. So I guess that makes more sense. Now there's something that we don't see that should be exciting, and it's a new Pixel theme app that'll allow you to change the font, icon shape, and accent colors. Someone found this actually in the actual code. It's not available yet. It will be available in the Play Store. And once it's available in the Play Store, you'll be able to change all of those different settings. So that part will be nice as well. Now they've also updated the share sheet to show previews. I wasn't able to get this to pop up, but if we went to share this, it will give you a little bit more information if we share through here. So we can share whatever we have to all of these different apps, and it will give a preview if it's an image or something like that. I haven't seen that myself, but it should do that. Now, if you have the Android feedback app, which you should if you have the beta, and you should be using it to give feedback if you find some issues, it definitely helps. So we'll go into the feedback beta, and then we can go into settings, and in settings we have enabled dark theme. So now it will match everything. So we have that as well. And they've just changed the way it works a little bit. Now when it comes to screenshots, they've changed that a little bit. So let's take a quick screenshot, and there we go. It shows up as a little notification bubble. We'll tap on this, it'll open. And you'll see it no longer has rounded corners or shows the notch in the screenshot. So that's a little update as well. If you're familiar with the monthly security updates that Google pushes to the Pixel devices and the Essential phone and a few others, they've also pushed the security update to the Android Q update. So it has everything that's in the April 2019 security update. So if you haven't seen that video, check it out. I posted it just before this one. You can check it out for all of those changes. Now, aside from the things I've already shown you, there's some things they've changed in the back. Background. So there's more support for foldable displays. I'll show you the animation here that they have on their website, but there's also a new emulator to test that out. They've also made privacy more important by limiting access to device identifiers. So things like your serial number or your IMEI that don't change, they made that more difficult to gain access to, and also your MAC address. So when you connect to a different Wi-Fi network, it actually randomizes that MAC address per network so that it doesn't identify your device specifically. Also, if you're an app developer and you use the microphone, you can change directional or zoom the mic for actual sound. And then app developers can now get the thermal status of a device. So maybe you're using an app and it's sort of using a lot of power. Maybe it's a game. They can actually throttle the processor in order to cool the device down if it was getting really warm in the back. And then there's also more prominent isolated storage, and that's pretty much it. So those are the major changes that we've seen so far. There may be a few here and there. And if you found any, let us know in the comments below if you found anything else that's a little more prominent. And that seems to be it. Everything seems to be working well. However, beta 1 was a little bit buggy, and those notification bubbles are a little bit buggy. So I'll probably turn those off using ADB. So that's a whole other thing that seemed to not work at first and took a few minutes to actually enable. But let me know if you found anything. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I do in all my videos. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If not, the other one's okay too. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.